have a chance to talk about another thing, which is scale. In slideshows and websites, you don't really know the scale of something, but now you do. So we said earlier that the context of work of art changes it, right? So everybody has this context. And then the psychology of the cover. Last week when we saw you just have a red background, you know, it would seem more edgy because this figure with the open mouth is always just right on the edge between fear and pain on the one hand and goofy kid stuff on the other. And when you put this little goofy guy in, it's goofy. I don't have to be worried that, you know, this is from Waters. Because how you surround a figure, you're spinning it, and you could spin it in different ways. I mean, and then it's the language, the syntax of simple kidro, simple line. You know, this is a tough one to pull off, to be innocent and not just pretend to be innocent, to really be innocent. And it's hard to do when you're sophisticated, you know all the old master painters, you've copied half of them. Love them all, and then how do you do that? And let yourself up. And it seems so spontaneous and it's so huge. The chicken. The chicken. Wait, let's talk about the chicken. Because the chicken is the subject of the poem. Big Baby is born in the dark, in the wild. Big Baby is crying. Big Baby is alone. The chicken is here. The chicken is there. The chicken is everywhere. Eat the chicken, Big Baby, eat. The chicken is good for you. The chicken is protein. No, Big Baby won't eat. The chicken is Big Baby's friend. Since dawn, they sang together in a sad, silent song. At dusk, they stood side by side in a dark, empty space. It is cold here. Chilled mineral water is dripping down their cheeks, yet colors of hope are glimmering in the air, radiating inside their chests, keeping Big Baby happy and the chicken strong. So yes, the chicken. You can't say the word chicken and that's fine. So what does the chicken represent? Nature?